Ladies and gentlemen, the secret word tonight is street. S-T-R-E-E-T.
Really?
You bet your life! The more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers of America present Groucho Marx in You Bet Your Life, the comedy quiz series produced and transcribed from Hollywood. And here he is, the one, the only...
Groucho!
That's me, Groucho Marx. Well, here I am again, and tonight I've got $5,000 in cash. If I had any sense, I'd take that money and skip. Now then, Mr. Fenneman, who's first to try for the $5,000?
Well, Groucho, we asked if there were any newlyweds present tonight, and just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Mr. and Mrs. Henry I. Hara. And here they are. Folks, come in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Well, welcome, kids, for the DeSoto Plymouth dealers. Say the secret word and you win $100. It's a common word, something you see every day. Newlyweds, eh? O'Hara?
That's right.
What kind of name? That's an Irish name, isn't it? O'Hara? Well, isn't that an Irish name?
No, it's a Japanese name.
Oh, Japanese name.
Yes. Carrie was really my nickname. It was taken from my Japanese name, Kaoru.
Kaoru? What does that mean?
Oh, it means fragrance.
Well, that seems to be quite appropriate in connection with you, Carrie. What does it mean in English? It means fragrance, eh?
Guess so.
Means the same in Japanese as it does in English, eh? Isn't that odd? And we're both on the same train. Where are you from, Carrie?
I was born in Sacramento, and I've lived in Los Angeles.
Oh. How long have you lived there?
Oh, I'd say the balance of my so many years since I was born.
And your name is Henry O'Hara?
Ihara,
huh?
Yes.
What kind of a name is that?
Japanese.
Oh, well, you both had both Japanese, huh?
Yes.
Do you have a pet name for Henry here?
Well, I call him Butch-chan sometimes.
Call him what?
Butch-chan.
Butch-chan?
Yes.
What is that, like Butch?
Oh, no.
What is Butch-chan?
Little boy.
Oh.
Little boy.
Look who's talking, little boy. What do you call Carrie when you're all alone, Henry?
Well, I call her Oi sometimes.
Oi? Just one Oi?
Yes.
Do young Japanese people here observe the old country customs of courtship and marriage?
I believe some families do. In our case, we had a go-between man.
Yeah, a what?
A go-between man.
A go-between? What's a go-between man?
Well, it's an old custom.
Is he related to an oi?
No. No, it's a very old custom carried on by families that like traditions. And they used to arrange the marriage for a young girl and a potential bridegroom. And if they thought they were suited for each other, well, he would arrange a marriage. And sometimes without seeing each other, they would get married.
Well, now, you mean if when you wanted to kiss Henry here, you had to kiss the go-between man instead? It sounds like interesting work. How do I go about getting a job like that? I've heard that a wife in Japan has an entirely different status than a wife in this country. Is that true, Carrie?
Yes, the man is the lord of the house, and he usually flings his authority around.
Throws his weight around,
that's
you mean?
Right. The women used to walk behind their husbands, and they would usually be carrying the load. Well, this is an old custom.
Well, I think that's a good idea. I think if a woman's got a load, she should walk him back. I like the American customs better, where the woman walks in front of the man. At least you know what you're chasing. Do you speak Japanese, Carrie?
Yes, I do.
Is that so? I speak it very well myself, you know. Could you say something in Japanese?
Oh, I'd be very glad to.
Well, I understood that very well. That's a good deal like English. Well, say something else in Japanese. Tell me what you think of me, and be sure it's in Japanese. Now, go ahead.
Groucho-san, anata hontou ni kawaii kata desu ne.
Is that so? I'm not sure I ought to have you translate what you just said. I'll hire a go-between. Henry, do you know what she just said?
Well, she said that you're a very cute man.
Oh, come now. Do you really think I'm cute? I'll have my father call on you tomorrow morning. We'll work something out. Well, you're a wonderful couple, and I've enjoyed talking. Look how cute they are, standing there holding hands. Now, in just 1 minute, you're going to play You Bet Your Life for a chance at the $5,000. That's the highest amount we've ever had on this show. Now, I want you to pay close attention to some important information.
You know, most of us want two things from a new car: a smooth, comfortable ride and a really powerful engine. And these are the very reasons why so many folks are seeing and buying the new 1951 DeSoto. No other car rides like it. For this proud new DeSoto has been designed to give you the maximum in riding comfort. For example, new Auraflow shock absorbers cushion your ride, make it really smooth on even the bumpiest road. And DeSoto's new higher-powered engine gives you the kind of pep, the kind of get-up-and-go you've always dreamed of getting from a new car. Yes, you can always depend on this new DeSoto engine to deliver the power you want the very instant you want it. And DeSoto's completely waterproof ignition system adds to engine efficiency and dependability even in the wettest weather. Well, there you have it, folks. Riding comfort and real power. Two reasons why no other car rides like this new 1951 DeSoto. And, of course, it's DeSoto that lets you drive without shifting. So come in tomorrow to your DeSoto Plymouth dealer and find out just what a pleasure this new DeSoto is to ride, to drive, to own.
Now, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected fictional animals and birds. Now, have you met Mr. Panama?
How do you do?
How do you do?
Glad to know you.
Glad to know you.
All right, now here's your first question.
Want me to tell him the rules, Groucho?
Yes, explain the rules, if you remember them, that is.
Let's see. You bet as much of your
$20... I've got too much confidence in you.
You bet as much of your $20 as you want on each of four questions, and the couple that earns the most money gets a chance at the $5,000 DeSoto Plymouth question at the end of the show.
All right, now, you selected fictional animals and birds. Here's your first question. How much are you going to bet? You have
$20.
$19, okay. What kind of an animal is Dumbo?
It's an elephant.
An elephant is right.
And you're off to a good start. You have $39.
Remember, you're going for $5,000 tonight. Now, how much of the $39 are you going to try on this one?
$38.
$38. What kind of an animal is Ferdinand?
It's a bull.
It's a bull.
You're really climbing. You have $77.
Here's your third question. How much of the 77? 78, you're going to bet? You only have... He wants to borrow a dollar from somebody in the audience. That's really inflation when you bet $78 and you only have 77. This is a ridiculous world we're coming into, isn't it? Why don't you bet 88? 76, that's right. The spirit is 76. What kind of an animal is Francis?
It's a donkey.
A donkey is all right. It's a mule. It's a donkey.
You have now climbed to $153.
Well, you're $153, and here's your last chance to beat the other couples. How much are you going to bet?
The whole thing.
The works. What kind of an animal is Rudolph?
It's a red-nosed reindeer.
A red-nosed reindeer.
And you wind up with $306.
Just before we went on the air, Groucho, we selected a married man from our studio audience, Mr. Ted Stewart. His partner is Carolyn Leonetti, who runs a charm school, and here they are. Folks, come in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Well, welcome, folks, for the DeSoto Plymouth dealers. Say the secret word and divide $100 in cash. It's a common word, something you see every day. Miss Caroline Leonetti, huh?
That's right.
You're from a charm school, eh?
Yes, that's right.
You're very charming. I'm charmed to meet you.
Thank you. It's nothing at all. Tonight I happen to be dripping with charm.
Oh, thank you.
As long as you're from a charm school, I wanted you to know you're not dealing with any clodhopper here. You're very charming, too. What is your name, Mr. Stewart?
Ted Stewart.
Ted Stewart.
Well, thank you very much.
If you think I'm going to kiss your hand, you're crazy. Where are you from, Ted? That's such a short name for such a big man.
Well, my full name is Theophilus Noel Newman Roosevelt Stewart, but they call me Ted for short.
Oh.
I was born in Georgia, spent most of my boyhood days in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and I've been out here since 1919.
Uh-huh.
Los Angeles.
You like it better up here, up north?
I like it here, out here in the West, yes.
Uh-huh. Are you married, Caroline?
No, I'm not.
In that case, let me kiss your hand again. What kind of work do you do, Ted?
I'm a retired police officer from Los Angeles Police Department.
Oh. Does your wife work?
Well, yes. She doesn't work.
Not even around the house?
Well, yes, she works around the house.
How did you meet this parasite?
Well, I was walking my beat in the military manor out here on the Miracle Mile back in 1939 on August the 2nd, and she jaywalked, and she ran across the street and she got a bus...
You said street, and you and Miss Leonetti are going to split $100.
It's $50 for you,
and it's $50 for you.
Well, anyway.
Carry on. This is wonderful.
I gave her a citation for jaywalking because she nearly created an accident. So I took her name and address, and I went over to see her the next day, and I wound up paying for that citation, and 3 months later, why, I married the girl in Las Vegas.
Is she still in Las Vegas?
She's here.
Oh. Well, let's get charming again, shall we?
<All right. laughs>
How was that? Did I make you think of a genteel foreign nobleman?
Well, in a way, yes.
In that case, you better count your rings. Last time I counted my rings, I discovered I was the oldest living thing in California. What charm school are you from, Leonetti, Caroline?
Well, from the Carol and Leonetti Charm School.
Oh, and what are the main things you teach at this charm school?
Well, we have, of course, the basic courses like personal grooming, posture, carriage, balance and walk, diet and exercising, makeup, hairstyling, social graces, etiquette, fashion, practically everything that goes to making a woman even charming.
I see. Well, don't people do this normally without going to school?
Well,
can a fellow take a bath without going to a school?
We like to think that we help the women to develop their own inherent charm. We think that every woman is charming, but we'd like to help her develop
line
even
she's
more.
Got, huh? How much does all this rigmarole cost?
Well, right here in Hollywood, the complete course costs $195. However, I've just completed for those women all over the United States who can't be right here in Hollywood what I call a home study course, the 24 Steps to Loveliness, for only $5.
Well, let's pretend I'm a young girl hot out of Vassar. And I want some charm. Now, what would you do first?
First of all, we have to determine the shape of the face. For instance, each woman's face falls in a geographical, or rather, a geometrical type of design.
Yes.
Like
most...
It is geography.
Most of the women I know, their face falls the minute they see me.
Well, for instance, a woman might have a round...
What is the ideal face?
Well, the ideal shaped face is what we call the oval. And if we wanted to measure it out, it would measure like, the eyes should be one eye apart. And the width of the face should be the width of five eyes. And the eyebrow should be the width of an open eye above the eye. And the mouth should be the length of two eyes.
Well, I've counted 36 eyes so far. I'd be better off going out with a potato. I mean, a sweet potato. Well, is all this supposed to hook a husband for your pupils? Or do you teach them specifically how to do that, too?
Yes, we do. We have a class called Your Man in Marriage.
Your Man in Marriage?
Yes.
And what does that course consist of? How to use a blackjack?
No, not exactly. We try and help to teach the women to set the scene, you know, preparing, the room with flowers and...
You mean snaring the sucker, it's called.
No, I mean, she usually finds out the kind of clothes he likes, the colors, and perhaps even his favorite perfume or cologne, and then after they've come home, why, to thank him very graciously for the evening.
Mm-hmm. What does she usually say at the conclusion of an evening?
Well,
let's say he's taken her to the movies and he's bought her popcorn and chewing gum. And they sat in the balcony and she had her shoes off and now they're going home. One shoe. They can't find the one shoe. It's still rolling around the balcony.
Well, she might say when she comes home, Bill, I certainly want to thank you for the very lovely evening. It was very nice, and I did enjoy the picture.
Now, suppose he wants to kiss her.
Well, this depends entirely upon the individual woman and upon the individual man.
Well, let's say it was you.
Well, if it was me, I would say it depend upon the man.
Well, let's say it was me.
Groucho, I would kiss you the first time we were out.
Well, what are we waiting for?
That was very sweet.
I gave you a real motherly kiss that time. Eh? And so did you. Now, did your wife do all that to you when she hooked you, Ted?
Well, if she did, I didn't know it.
You mean you were unconscious? See there, Caroline, your course is all wrong. The only thing a girl needs to get a husband is a go-between man. You know what a go-between man is?
No, I don't.
And what are you laughing at?
I'm trying to be polite.
She's from a charm school, all right. She'll laugh at anything. Well, you've both been very charming. In fact, all three of us have been charming. Now you're going to play your bet your life. You beat our other two couples, and you get a chance at the $5,000 question. I can't tell you how much the first couple won, but George Fenneman, or Squire, as he's known in recent weeks, is going to remind our listeners.
The Japanese newlyweds won $306.
Here we go. Let's say Ohio can build you $20. You selected blondes. How much of your $20 are you going to bet on your first question?
Shall we bet 15?
Let's make it 18.
All right.
$18. My friend Imer is a blonde. What's her real name?
Marie Wilson is right.
You're on your way. You have $38. Remember, you're going for $5,000 tonight. How much of the 38 are you going to try?
How about 35?
35 is good.
Right, 35.
What is the name of the petite little Norwegian skating star? She's a blonde.
Sonja Henie.
Sonja Henie is right.
You now have $73.
How much of the 73 are you going to try?
70?
Let's go 70, yes.
All right.
70. What's the name of the blonde who starred in the film version of Annie Get Your Gun?
Betty Hutton.
Betty Hutton is right.
$143.
You've got $143. Here's your last chance to be the other couples. How much are you going to go for?
The whole thing.
The whole thing, yeah.
All right.
All right. What is the name of the blonde singing and dancing star of Fox movies? She's got beautiful legs, too.
Oh, Betty Grable.
Betty Grable is right. Soda Plymouth dealers.
You wind up with $286.
Thanks and good luck from the Soda Plymouth dealers. They pull a string back here and I say, thanks and good luck from the Soda Plymouth dealers. Right. Three cars, I said.
Just before we went on the air, we searched through our studio audience for the oldest man present, and he turned out to be Mr. Hannes von Jana. His partner is a nightclub cigarette girl selected by the studio audience, Miss Inga Borg. And here they are. Folks, come on in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome, kids, to You Bet Your Life. Say the secret word and you'll divide $100. It's a common word, something you see every day. You're the oldest man in the audience?
No, I'm a cigarette girl.
Oh. Well, you'll have to pardon me. My eyes are not what they used to be. Hannes von Jana? You must be the oldest man, huh? Hannes von Jana, huh? What is your name in English?
Hannes von Jana.
I think I know your brother, Hannes and Truly. Is that him? Hannes von Jana. Sounds just the same in English. What kind of a name is that, Hannes?
Norwegian.
Norwegian, huh? Now, you were selected as the oldest man in our audience. How old are you? 85?
No.
90?
Older than that.
I'll do my best, but I'm no kid either, you know. Are you 91?
No.
95?
Keep going.
This is getting to sound like the price of coffee. Okay, I'll shoot the moon. Are you 100 years old?
More than that.
200? That's as high as I'll go. I give up, Hannes. How old are you?
102.
102 years old? Well, that's magnificent, Hannes. You don't look a day over 100.
Thank you.
So
Well, as a matter of fact, you look like I thought you were about 70. He doesn't look more than 70, does he? And his grip. Well, you're a model of preservation. I've never seen anything like it, Hannes. It gives me encouragement. What is your name?
Ingeborg.
Oh, Ingeborg. Is that anything like ironing board?
No, I don't think so.
I'll call you Ink, huh?
All right.
Are you married, Ingeborg?
No.
Not married, huh?
Mm-mm.
Well, you're a cigarette girl. Where do you peddle these weeds?
In Ciro's.
In Ciro's, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Do you sell smokes behind a tobacco counter?
No, I usually walk around and sell cigarettes on the floor.
Well, is that where the customers are, on the floor? Wouldn't it be cheaper for the management to install a cigarette machine?
Yes, but there's a lot of difference between a cigarette machine and a cigarette girl.
Really? You mind if I take another look at you? Yes, by George, you're right. There is a difference. I never saw a cigarette machine wearing high heels. I've seen a lot of heels around a cigarette machine. Now, Hannes, in what year were you born?
January the 21st, 49.
1849. Who was the first president you can remember distinctly?
Abraham Lincoln, the first Republican president.
Well, a man has to be pretty old to remember a Republican president. What would you say is the secret of your long life, the longevity?
I think the secret of longevity is to be happy. Mm-hmm. Every day when a man wakes up, he has the choice whether he shall be unhappy or happy. I have chosen to be happy.
That's a wonderful philosophy. Well, it's been a privilege and a pleasure, Hannes. And Ingeborg, don't let me catch you flirting with this fellow. He wasn't born yesterday, you know. All right, now let's see how you two are going to make out in the battle for the $5,000. You run your $20 into more than our other couples. I can't tell you how much they won, but George is going to remind our listeners.
The Japanese newlyweds are still leading with $306.
Here we go. Let's see how high you can build your $20. You selected capitals of foreign countries. Now, here's your first question. How much are you going to bet?
$15.
What is the capital of Denmark?
Copenhagen.
Copenhagen is right.
That's a good start. You have $35.
Remember, you're going for $5,000 tonight. That's the highest prize we've ever had on this show. You're going to bet you have $35. How much are you going to risk now?
$30.
What is the capital of Egypt?
Cairo.
Cairo is right.
Now you climb to $65.
Here's your third question. How much of the $65 are you going to go for?
$60.
What is the capital of Norway?
Oslo.
Oslo is right.
You now have $125.
He ought to know the answers. He's been around for 102 years. Here's your last chance to beat the other couple. How much will you bet?
$120.
All right, what is the capital of Hungary? Talk it over.
Oh, Belgrade.
No, I'm sorry, it's Budapest.
Budapest. Oh,
oh,
I didn't
that's
have
a shame.
Them there.
I'm sorry.
You wind up with $5. We can't let this happen,
can't let them go away with $5. I'm going to give you one more question, get it right, and you'll win $10. And please, no help in the audience. In what sport do you wear tennis shoes?
Tennis.
Tennis is right, huh? We're there, Ingeborg. All right, come on, number 15.
And Groucho, that means that the Japanese newlyweds with $306 get the chance at the DeSoto Plymouth $5,000 question.
Well, thanks and good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealers, Hannes. Now, in just 1 minute, I'll ask them the question, but first, here's something of interest to everyone. Yeah.
Folks, of all the new cars on the highway today, none rides like, none is more beautiful than the new 1951 DeSoto. From its distinctive new front end to the graceful sweep of the rear fenders, this great new DeSoto is a car that not only commands attention, but admiration as well. Just open the door of this stunning car, and you'll discover the most beautiful interior you've ever laid eyes on. Look at the richly grained new instrument panel that goes right down to the floor. See how the controls and dials are conveniently grouped. It'll convince you of the extra thought, the extra care, and the style that went into the new DeSoto. Then, sit in DeSoto's comfortable chair-high seats and inspect the smart, durable upholstery and all the distinctive interior details. Yes, folks, there's no doubt about it. The new 1951 DeSoto is the most stylish car on the highway today. And to enjoy a ride that's just as outstanding, visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer tomorrow. For you'll find no other car rides like the new 1951 DeSoto.
And Groucho, here are the Japanese newlyweds all set for the $5,000 question.
All right, are you kids ready? You a little O'Hara, you? Here we go for $5,000. I'll give you 15 seconds to decide on a single answer between you. Think carefully and please no help from the audience. Here it is. You ready? According to popular legend, the island of Manhattan was purchased by the Dutch for $24. For $5,000, tell me, who was the Dutch governor who made this famous purchase? What is the answer you two have decided upon?
Lord Baltimore?
No, I'm sorry. It's Peter Minuet, first governor of what is now New York. I'm sorry, that's the correct answer. So that means the big question next week will be worth $5,500. Well, you lost the big money, but how much did they win in the quiz, George?
$306.
Congratulations, and thanks to both of you and to all of our contestants on the show tonight.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $5,500. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember, just be sure to visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
Folks, here's a rhyme from the National Safety Council. The rules for driving safely add up to only three: common sense and caution, and common courtesy. You Bet Your Life, transcribed from Hollywood, is produced by John Goodell, directed by Robert Dwan and Bernie Smith. Music by Jerry Fielding. This is George Fenneman signing off for the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast. Ladies and gentlemen, the secret word tonight is hand. H-A-N-D.
Really?
You bet your life! The more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers of America present Groucho Marx in You Bet Your Life, the comedy quiz series produced and transcribed from Hollywood. And here he is, the one, the only,
Groucho!
That's me, Groucho Marx.
Well, tonight we've got $5,500 for one of our couples, George. More than we've ever given away before. I hope somebody takes it away from me. It's been keeping me awake nights. Now then, Deacon Fenneman, who's first to try for the $5,500?
Well, Groucho, we invited some old-time Western characters to the program tonight. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Mr. Fred Noller. And we invited an Indian to be his partner, Mr. Bill Wilkerson. And here they are, gentlemen. Meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome, gentlemen. Welcome for the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers. And if you say the secret word, you'll divide $100. It's a common word, something you always have with you. Let's see, a Wild Westerner and an Indian, eh? Mr. Fred Noller, you're the Westerner, I presume?
Yep.
Where are you from, partner?
Arizona Territory. That's Arizona before it became a state.
Oh. How long you been out here?
No, I've been out here since right after the war.
Which war are you referring to?
The last one.
Bill Wilkerson? You're the Indian, huh?
Yes, sir.
How?
How? Because my father and mother were Indians.
Hug. Where are you from, Bill?
I was born in Indian Territory.
You two weren't neighbors, were you?
Well, not quite. But I was born in Bartlesville, Indian Territory, which is now Oklahoma.
Oh. Isn't Bill Wilkerson a kind of an odd name for an Indian?
Well, yes. But we took that name from the missionaries about 160 years ago that were from Boston.
Mm-hmm. Is that all you took from them? Just
That's all we were able to take at that time.
So, well, don't you have a tribal name?
I have my own Indian name.
What is that?
Okunstata.
Oh, well, I used to play it three-handed. I'd never played the... How did you get that name?
An old Indian lady by the name of Terrapin.
Terrapin?
Terrapin, like a dryland turtle. And she prophesied that I would talk and sing before many strange people.
You couldn't get a stranger crowd than this out here. Are you married, Bill?
Yes, sir.
Well, you're a brave, all right. Do Indians have a regular marriage contract, or is it just a kind of a blanket contract?
In the old days, it was a blanket contract. Today, we have to abide by the rules and regulations.
What tribe are you from, Bill?
I'm a Cherokee.
Is that so? Did you know I was a Blackfoot?
You don't look like one.
Well, I'm not a Blackfoot Indian. I'm just a Blackfoot. Those cheap socks I wear. Oh. I used to know an Indian who was a lawyer. He was a Sioux Indian. Do you know any of them? Well, old-timer, what sort of work do you do?
I work down at Knott's Berry Farm down here in Orange County.
Knott's Berry Farm?
Mm-hmm.
I know what it's not, but what is it?
Well, it's a berry farm. A fella by the name of Knott started it.
What is a berry farm?
Well, it's a pretty good size spread now. He's got 300-400 acres there, and he's got big chicken dining rooms and steakhouse where he serves a lot of people.
How many people do you feed out there?
Well, I reckon about the biggest time they had was last Father's Day. There was about 11,000, a little over, out there for dinners.
On Father's Day, you saved 11,000 dinners?
That's right.
Well, that's typical. 11,000 mothers decided to celebrate Father's Day by letting the old man take them all out to dinner. Now, let's see how well you work together as a team. Now, in just 1 minute, you're going to play your Bet Your Life for a chance at $5,500. But first, there's something of importance I want you to hear about.
When you drive the new 1951 DeSoto, you'll enjoy added comfort and pleasure thanks to DeSoto's famous Auraflow shock absorbers, a longer wheelbase, and a full cradled ride. Yes, no other car rides like a DeSoto. And DeSoto also gives you a wonderful feeling of safety and security. Just suppose you need to stop, and in a hurry. Well, DeSoto's big new 12-inch brakes will quickly bring you to a safe, smooth stop. No other car in America has larger brakes. And DeSoto's chair-high seats let you sit up comfortably with a full view of the road ahead. There's more visibility, too, with the new, wider, deeper windshield and rear window. And should a blowout occur, DeSoto's safety rim wheels help keep the car under control. Well, that, folks, should give you a pretty good idea of the new DeSoto's greater safety. And when you add to that its extra comfort, you'll discover why DeSoto is your best buy for the years ahead. So visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer tomorrow and see this beautiful 1951 DeSoto for yourself.
Now, let's see if you'll get the chance at the $5,500. George, Mr. Fenneman, would you mind explaining the rules to this old trapper over here?
You bet as much of your $20 as you want on each of four questions, and the couple that earns the most money gets a chance at the $5,500 DeSoto Plymouth question at the end of the show.
All right, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected fighting presidents. Here's your first question. How much of the 20 will you bet?
Just make it about 18.
Go ahead.
Might as well shoot
it. Yeah, okay.
18.
This one thing, if we don't win, you won't be too disappointed, will you?
No, I won't, but I think you will. I want everybody to win on this show.
Thank you.
It's not my money. Now, what was the... what was the name of the president who led the Union forces during the Civil War?
Grant.
Grant.
U.S. Grant is right.
And you fellas are on your way. You have $38.
Remember, you're going for $5,500. Now, how much of the $38 would you bet on your second question?
35 and a half.
Yeah. All right. 35 and a half. What is the name of the president who served with the 129th Field Artillery during the First World War?
Truman.
Harry Truman is right. If he's an Indian, I'm a monkey's uncle. I don't think that couldn't be true.
You have 73.
Get this massive mathematician here.
I had it for a minute.
Where do you live? I bet you don't know where you live.
Yes, I do.
15,300.
I live up there.
There you are.
You don't. You have. Here it is, right here. $73.50.
All right. Now, how much of this are you going to risk this time?
73. No, 70.
70.
Leave three and a half.
Let me get a hamburger out of this.
Chief said he hopes to get enough for a hamburger out of this. What was the name of the president who was a major general in the Civil War? He was assassinated by a disappointed office seeker.
Major general. He ain't saying which side of the fence he was on. Could have been in the South or the Yankees.
Oh, I'm sorry. It was James Garfield. There's only been three presidents assassinated. You should have known that.
You now have $3.50.
See how quickly Fenneman figured that out.
Yeah. Well, that's it all.
Sure.
All right, here's your last chance to be the other couple. How much will you bet? Everything?
Oh, sure.
What is the name of the president who was the hero of the Battle of New Orleans? He was called Old Hickory.
Andrew Jackson.
Andrew Jackson is right.
Wait a minute, fellas. We can't let you go away with just $7, so...
No, you can't even get a hamburger for $7. Can't have anybody going away from here broke. I'll give you one more question, get it right, and you win $10. No help from the audience, please. In what sport do you wear tennis shoes?
In tennis.
Tennis is right!
Thank you.
Good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
We invited some people to the show tonight, Groucho, who give intelligence tests. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Mrs. Jean Judson. Her partner is a married man from the audience, Mr. William Scher. And here they are. Folks, come in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Well, welcome to You Bet Your Life. Say the secret word and divide $100 between you. It's a common word, something you always have with you. Now, let's see. We have an intelligence tester here. If I was smart, I'd leave by the back door and quietly. Mrs. Jean Judson, you're the intelligence tester, eh? Where are you from, Jean?
I'm from all over Groucho.
You're from all over Groucho? I wish you were. Where are you from specifically, Jean?
I was born in Chicago, Groucho.
You were born in Chicago?
Yes. Then I went to Kansas, then to Idaho, been to Minnesota.
What were you doing? Were you selling vacuum cleaners? Why were you tripsing and traipsing around the country?
Well, my father's job changed, and then my mother's job changed, and then I finally got out of college and found my own.
Found your own mother and father?
No.
That's kind of sad, a woman searching all over America for her parents. Where were they at the time? Were they with you when you were born?
I think so.
Well, that's handy, I think. Now, what's your hometown, William Shearer?
Louisville, Kentucky.
Louisville, Kentucky, huh? What sort of work do you do?
Well, when I was on the road, I sold ladies' lingerie.
Well, that's pleasant. Intimate. What are you doing now?
Well, I'm waiting for my orders to report to the Army. I'm drafted.
Oh. Well, I don't know what to say about that, except that that is not the ideal place to sell lingerie. You're married, too, huh?
Yes, I am.
You said you don't look it. You look like you're enjoying yourself. William, are you sure you're married?
Well, 5 years.
Well, could you prove it? Could you let me see your marriage license?
I don't have those with me.
Slippery, aren't you? Huh? I'll bet you $10 right now I can prove you're not married. You want to bet?
I haven't got $10.
Well, I lose. If you don't have $10, you're married, all right. Yes, you do.
Thank you.
You ought to get acquainted with the Indian we had out here. He can lend you money. He's got a couple of bucks at home. If I keep on chattering, I'll not only prove I'm a dope, but also that I'm broke. Let's talk about this intelligence testing. Who do you work for, Gene? Oh, I forgot I was talking to intelligence. I beg your pardon. Whom do you work for? Have to be careful. Somebody from the New Yorker might be listening. Who do you work for, Gene?
I work for the Educational Testing Service.
Well, what kind of a racket is that? What do they do?
We test the high school seniors who are applying for entrance into college.
Let me see you try it on Bill over here. Huh? Ask him some questions. Go ahead, Gene.
Well, Bill, if it takes 3 men 6 days to finish a job, how many men can finish that same job in 12 days?
I'd say 4.
Well, why don't you? Now, Gene, what would you say? Would you say he's right?
No, the right answer to that is a man and a half.
That may be the right answer, but where are you going to hire a half a man? Of course, you could hire one, but I won't be out of work until summer. Now, Gene, I don't think that was a fair question. Try another one where the answer is a whole man. Now, go ahead. What's another of your test questions?
Well, here's one for you, Groucho. If you see a train approaching very fast on a track, and you see
that... It's a good place for it.
And if you see that a piece of rail is missing from the track, what would you do?
I'd get off and take the American Airlines. Well, I have a choice of what?
You have a choice of 3 answers. Would you look for a piece of missing rail to fit in? Would you call an ambulance? Or would you signal the engineer to stop the train?
Well, let's see. Is the train going north or south?
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, huh?
No.
It would to me if I was on the train. Okay, let's say I call an ambulance. Am I right?
No, you should signal the engineer to stop the train.
That's not true. By the time I figured out the question, the correct thing to do would be to call an ambulance. Well, I've learned a lot about intelligence quotients. Is that what you call it?
That's right.
Now, let's see if you two are smart enough to run your $20 into more than our other couples. And then you can take away the $5,500 from me. Now, Mr. Fannerman, that's George, is offstage to remind our listeners how much the first couple won.
The Western character and the Indian won $7.
All right, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected famous hotels. Here's your first question. How much will you bet?
18.
He's an undercover man. He used to sell lingerie. In what city is the Palmer House Hotel?
Chicago.
Chicago, Chicago.
And on your way, you have
$38.
Remember, you're going for $5,500 tonight. That's the most we ever had. How much of your $38 are you going to bet this time?
Mm-hmm.
How much?
$35.
In what city is the Mark Hopkins Hotel?
Atlantic City?
I'm sorry, kids. It's San Francisco. You should have known that. It's a very famous hotel, and you've been on the road all these years.
You have $3 now.
Oh, that's a shame. Here's your third question. How much of the three you're going to bet?
Not bet at all.
In what city is the Townhouse Hotel?
Boston?
Los Angeles. It's right down here on Wilshire Boulevard.
They've gone...
Let me another question. This is for $10. If you get this right, I'll give you $10. And please, no coaching. Now, think carefully. This is a toughie. Who is Grant's tomb?
Grant.
General Grant is right. Thanks for good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth
Dealers. Groucho, we invited some beauty contest winners to the program tonight, and just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Vera Miles. Her partner is a bachelor, Mr. Victor Desney. Folks, come in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Well, welcome for the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers. Say the secret word and you'll divide $100. It's a common word, something you always have with you. A beauty contest winner. Now you're talking. This calls for a little closer inspection. Well, your name is Vera Miles?
Yes, that's right.
That's a very pretty name, and you're a very beautiful girl. Where are you from?
I'm originally from Kansas.
From Kansas?
Mm-hmm.
May I ask how old you are?
20.
Well, I'm a man of very few words, Vera. How about joining me at a big party after the show? Would you like that?
It sounds like a lot of fun.
How do you know it'll be a lot of fun? You don't even know who's going to be there. You want to know, Vera?
Yes, who's going to be there?
Just you and I. Does that still sound like fun? Answer yes or no, Vera.
No.
You don't have to answer quite so quick. Couldn't you at least cogitate about this thing a little bit? Why wouldn't you like to go out with me after the show?
Well, I'm married.
But for a man of few words, I certainly can talk myself out on a limb. Are you married?
Yes.
Mr. Victor Desney, you're still here, are you? No. Pardon me for ignoring you, but it's the best I can do at the moment. Where were you born, Mr. Desney?
I was born in Montenegro.
Well, how long since you were in Montenegro?
I left when I was just a baby. I went to Albania, the home of my parents.
Uh-huh. I must be slipping. I'm standing next to a beauty contest winner. And what am I doing? I'm talking about Yugoslavia and Albania. What are some of the beauty titles you've held?
I was first Miss Chamber of Commerce, and then Miss Wichita, and then Miss Kansas, and Miss Texas Grapefruit.
Were you a... What? Miss Texas Grapefruit?
Yes.
Was your father a squirt? Or...
And recently I've been chosen Miss New Made Margarine, and I had the honor to represent Kansas in the Miss America pageant.
Uh-huh. Tell us something about the Miss America contest. How long does it take to select a Miss America?
It takes a week so that the judges can completely get acquainted with the girls.
Those fools that go out for the Supreme Court, huh? Well, Victor, old boy, I'm sorry I'm neglecting you. It's not that I'm forgetting you exactly. It's just that I'm not thinking of you, that's all. Victor, suppose Vera wasn't married and you saw her walking along the street in Albania. How would you approach her and make a date with her?
Oh, I wouldn't do that.
You wouldn't, huh?
No.
Well, you can go back behind the Iron Curtain, you know.
Well, it is not allowed for a man in Albania to talk to a girl on the street. If it's absolutely necessary, for instance, like to ask for a direction, he has to go across the street and then holler at her.
He has to cross the street and holler at her if he wants a direction?
That's right.
Suppose that isn't the question he wants to ask. How is she going to be able to reach him and slap his face? Unless she's got the arm of a gorilla. In that case, he wouldn't want her. Now, Victor, do they have bathing beauty contests in Albania?
No.
Don't they bathe in Albania?
Yes, they do, but the women are not allowed to expose their bodies in public. If they want to go to the beach, they have to go to a separate beach where the men can see them.
Well, what's the sense of bathing then? Do they wear bathing suits on the women's beaches?
Yes, they do.
What kind? French bathing suits?
Oh, no. They are much longer and they cover much more.
How do you know? I thought men couldn't see them. Victor, you would fit right in down at Muscle Beach down in Santa Monica. Well, Vic, you've learned something of American women tonight. Do you think you'd prefer to marry an Albanian or an American woman? Now, think carefully now.
Well, Mr. Marx, that's very difficult to answer. The American women have charm, personality, and they are good companions. But the Albanian women are more humble and devoted to their husbands, especially have lovely hands.
Hands! Victor, you said hands, and you and Vera are going to split $100 between you. There you are, my lad. There's 50 for you and 50 for you, Vera.
Thank you.
Now, what were you saying about the girls over there? You say they work harder and they're more devoted to their husbands?
Yes, they...
I see. Well, what I would do if I was you is to marry an American girl, and if you want devotion, get yourself a St. Bernard dog. Well, you make a very attractive couple, and it's been a pleasure talking to you, and I'm sorry you're married, Vera. But as happens to all men. Now, you're going to play your bet your life for... You beat our other two couples, and you'll get a chance at the $5,500 DeSoto Plymouth question. I can't tell you how much the other couples won, but George is offstage to remind our listeners.
The Western character and the Indian are still leading with $7.
Here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected songs by Groucho Marx. Is that right?
Mm-hmm. We bet 19.
You're betting $19. Mm-hmm. Okay. Once I was happy, but now I'm forlorn. Like an old coat that is tattered and torn. I'm left in this wide world to fret and to mourn. Betrayed by a girl in her teens. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm terribly... The man on the flying trapeze.
Oh, geez.
I know I sing very badly, but I thought you'd recognize that.
You now have $1.
Okay, here's the second one. How much of the dollar are you going to bet?
Dollar.
A dollar. Boys and girls together, we could sing and waltz while Chico played the organ. Da, 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 da,
da, da. On the streets of the...
Well, that's close enough. On the sidewalks in New York.
Well, you're climbing a little bit. You have $2 now.
Ah, you're way up there, Vera. You're climbing up to $2. Now, how much are you going to bet on this one? All of it? Something. The world is made for fun and frolic. And so do I. And so do I. Some think it's well to be all melancholy, to pine and sigh, to pine and sigh. But I love to spend my time and I don't know if I get a chance to sing. And singing. Particularly, thank you all.
Wow, you have $4.
I got $4. It's your last chance to be the other couples. How much of the $4 are you going to bet?
Bet all of it.
You're going to bet all of it. That was a shame, that one question. Okay, it's your last chance to be the other couples. You're going to bet $4. Da, 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 da. They say such things and they do strange things. And da, 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 da. I'll never go there anymore. Da, 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 da.
The Bowery.
The Bowery is right. Yeah, you can't prove. I'm a winner.
I should say you did come through because your $8 total means that you get the chance of the DeSoto Plymouth $5,500 question.
Well, I'll ask them the big question in just 1 minute.
Here it is, the first week in April, and time to start thinking about getting your car ready for the warmer spring and summer months ahead. To put it in tip-top shape,
to add more life and real pep to the engine mile after mile after mile. Bring your car to a DeSoto Plymouth dealer for a spring tune-up. Here you get treated fairly and squarely, and you get expert service. For the mechanics at a DeSoto Plymouth dealer are trained in factory methods, and they use factory-designed and approved equipment. They'll inspect your car thoroughly, give your engine a complete tune-up, and check the electrical system. And they'll see to it that the radiator is drained and flushed, the chassis is inspected and lubricated, and do the countless other jobs that will assure you of thousands of miles of trouble-free driving. So no matter what kind of car you own, stop in for that really thorough spring tune-up at the sign of a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Any of the more than 3,000 authorized DeSoto Plymouth dealers will be happy to serve you promptly, efficiently, and at a fair price. All right, Groucho, and here's the beauty contest winner and the bachelor. Would you come over here, please? The winning couple, all ready for the DeSoto Plymouth $5,500 question.
All right, here we go. For $5,500, I'll give you 15 seconds to decide on a single answer between you. Think carefully and, of course, no help from the audience. Here it is. One of our greatest men isn't as well known as he should be. See if you can tell me who he is for $5,500. He was our first Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Who was he? All right, what's the answer you two have decided upon?
Johnson? No.
No, it's John Jay, oh. J-A-Y.
Oh, I knew it.
I'm terribly sorry. Well, that means the big question next week will be worth $6,000. Well, you lost the big money, but you won $8 in the quiz. Congratulations. And, $100 for the... Oh, you got $108? Well, that's not too bad.
No. Yeah.
Congratulations and thanks to both of you and to all of our contestants on the show tonight.
Thank you.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $6,000. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember... Just be sure to visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
Folks, here's a reminder from the National Safety Council. Don't stick your neck out in traffic. You Bet Your Life, transcribed from Hollywood, is produced by John Goodell. Directed by Robert Dwan and Bernie Smith. Music by Jerry Fielding. This is George Fenneman, signing off for the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast. Ladies and gentlemen, the secret word tonight is room. R-O-O-M.
Really?
You bet your life. The more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers of America present Groucho Marx in You Bet Your Life, the comedy quiz series produced and transcribed from Hollywood. And here he is... The one, the only...
Groucho! That's me, Groucho Marx. Well, here I am again tonight when one of our couples might take $6,000 away from me. George, that's a lot of money. An all-time record for You Bet Your Life. Now, Mr. Fenneman, who's first to try for the $6,000?
We invited some people from the Coast Guard to the show tonight, and also some daughters of the Army. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Miss Nancy Dunn and Yeoman Jean Scarcliffe. And here they are. Folks, meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome, youngsters, for the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers. Say the secret word and divide $100. It's a common word, something you'll find around the house. You're Nancy Dunn. You're an Army daughter?
Yes.
I didn't know the Army had any daughters. Those new secret weapons, I suppose. Where are you from, Nance?
I was born in Fort Bragg, North Carolina.
And you're from the Coast Guard?
Yes, sir.
Jean Scarlett, huh?
Yes, sir.
Where are you from, Jean?
Los Angeles.
Uh-huh. How old are you?
23.
And why are you 23?
Well...
You don't know why you're 23? Couldn't you say that it was because you were born 23 years ago? I hope you're more alert when you're on the coast looking for ships. Are you married, Jean?
No.
You know, you answered that pretty quick. You're an Army daughter?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Just what is an Army daughter?
It's a daughter of an Army officer that was born and raised in the Army.
I see. In other words, you've been in the Army since your early infantry. Is that right? jokes like that will bring back the cavalry. What does your father do in the Army, Nancy? What's his rank?
He's a colonel.
Oh, he doesn't do anything, huh? Where's your old man stationed?
He's
at Fort McGovern. What happened? Did he get his pants stuck on a nail? What does he do there?
He's a post commander, and he's the district commander of the Southern California Military District.
Are you married, Nancy?
No, I'm not.
You're not married. Why not? Aren't there any young men in the Army?
Oh, there are lots of them. I just haven't found the right one.
You haven't found the right one, huh? Where are you stationed, Jean?
Coast Guard recruiting station in Los Angeles.
Mm-hmm. And what do you do there, mostly?
Recruiting.
Really? That's odd, isn't it? Is that a recruiting station? He does recruiting. Tell me something about the Coast Guard. Is it a branch of the Navy?
No, it's under the Secretary of the Treasury.
Well, that's a nice warm place to be in times like these. How is it you're under the Secretary of the Treasury? Don't sailors belong in the Navy?
No, well, the Coast Guard was founded in 1790.
That's who found it?
Alexander Hamilton.
Oh. Well, that floored me, all right. I always thought that was a shoe company. And why don't sailors belong in the Navy?
Well, the Coast Guard...
Hamilton wouldn't know anything about it nowadays.
The Coast Guard was formed before there was a Navy. It was originally the Revenue Cutter Service.
I see. Well, I think we'd all be interested, Nancy, to hear the difference between being brought up in the Army and being brought up as a civilian. Could you give us some idea?
Well, when you live on a post, your life is more or less regulated by bugle calls.
You live on a post, you say? It's rather uncomfortable, isn't it? How do you mean your life is regulated by a bugle call?
Oh, the bugle gets you up in the morning and feeds you and puts you to bed at night and more or less runs your life in between.
That's quite a remarkable bugle, isn't it? If you ever meet one of those bugles single, my advice is marry it, Nancy. How about your private life in the Army? Do you ever go out with second lieutenants?
Oh, yes.
Do you also go out with officers?
A second lieutenant is an officer and is supposed to be a gentleman.
Wasn't that way at Gettysburg? Now, how long have you been in that uniform, Gene?
4 years.
Has anything exciting happened to you in the service?
Not while I was actually on active duty.
Well, I understand that, but what happened when you were on inactive duty?
Well,
apparently that's where most of the warfare is in the Coast Guard.
When I was in New York Christmas shopping once, I went to a department store to...
You were Christmas shopping in New York while you were in the Coast Guard?
Yes.
That's a pretty cushy job you've got. How come? Well, you wound up in Saks Fifth Avenue.
No, I didn't go there.
Where'd you go? The Army and Navy store? Where were you shopping, Gene?
Macy's.
Upstairs or down?
Downstairs.
And what happened?
Well, Well, I went into another store, and when I was coming out, well, they had a revolving door, and I dropped my packages in the middle of it, and while I was picking him up, well, some big lady came in the other way, and I went out in the sidewalks on my hands and knees, and there's a police officer there. He thought I was drunk. He was going to arrest me.
Well, let's find out something about the Coast Guard, Gene. What's the job of that branch of the service?
Well, we're known as the Police Force of the Sea. Our main function is to protect life and property at sea and ashore.
Mm-hmm. Well, suppose I'm out yachting between here and Catalina, and I'm having trouble now. What would you do?
Well, we'd go out and bring you back.
You're a big help. The trouble I'm having is with a blonde, and the trouble is she's heading for shore. Well, you're a very attractive couple, and Nancy, if I call to ask you for a date, I'll call Jean first, just to make sure the coast is clear. Now, let's see how well you work together as a team. You're just 1 minute. You're going to play You Bet Your Life for a chance at the $6,000 question. But first, here's something of interest to everyone.
Folks, one of the most important things you look for in a new car is real honest-to-goodness comfort. Well, you can stop looking right now, because you'll find that the new 1951 DeSoto is the most comfortable car on the road today. For when you slip behind the wheel of this proud new car, you'll be sitting on comfortable chair-high seats that give you a good, clear view of the road, and more real leg room and head and hat room as well. And when you get the new DeSoto actually on the highway, you'll feel DeSoto's new advanced design Auraflow shock absorbers go to work. No matter what kind of highway you're on, from a gentle rolling road to one with plenty of bumps and holes, you'll enjoy the comfort that comes from a really smooth ride. Yes, these are a few of the reasons why we say no other car rides like the beautiful new 1951 DeSoto. And, of course, it's DeSoto that lets you drive without shifting. So, folks, see the new DeSoto. Buy the new DeSoto.
No other car rides like a DeSoto.
All right, now let's see if you two will get a chance at the $6,000. Mr. Fenneman, would you explain the rules?
You bet as much of your $20 as you want on each of four questions. And the couple that earns the most money gets a chance at the DeSoto Plymouth $6,000 question at the end of the show.
Here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected stars of motion pictures. Here's your first question. How much will you try?
15.
Who plays the aging Broadway star in the picture All About Eve?
Betty Davis.
Betty Davis is right.
You're off to a good start. You have $35.
Remember, you're going for $6,000 tonight. Now, 34. How much of the 35 are you going to try?
34.
Who is the male star of Harvey?
James Stewart.
James Stewart is right. You're really finding you have $69. $69. Here's your third question. How much of the 69?
68.
What singing star is the lead in Mr. Music?
Bing Crosby.
Bing Crosby.
Climbed to $137.
You know, I'm quite offended at that answer. I was in that picture, too, you know.
What did you say?
I sang a little with Bing, yes. I drowned him out. That's why the picture did so well. How much have they got?
$137.
All right, now here's your last chance to beat the other. Next time anybody asks you about Mr. Music, say that I was the singing star. How much are you going to bet of your $137?
All of it.
What comedian played the lead in Watch the Baby?
Red Skelton.
Red Skelton is right.
And you wind up with a grand total of $274.
Thanks and good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealers.
Just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected a man from a pet shop, Mr. Phil Blanchard. His partner is a housewife from our audience, Mrs. Leah Ray Ross. Folks, meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome to You Bet Your Life. Say the secret word and divide $100. It's a common word, something you'll find around the house. You're from a pet store? Where are you from, Mr. Blanchard?
I'm from Grand Rapids, Michigan. Uh-huh. The furniture capital of the world.
Furniture capital of the world? Uh-huh. Is that the capital of Michigan?
No.
Well, what's the regular capital of Michigan?
Lansing?
Lansing, yes. I know, because I was once operated, and that's what they did. They did a lot of Lansing, and I'm sorry I started the whole thing. And, how long since you left Grand Rapids?
13 years ago.
18 years ago. And, what does your husband do, Mrs. Ross?
He merchandises women's dresses.
And do you allow that?
Brings in money.
Uh-huh. Does it bring in your husband?
No.
Do you have any hobbies?
Oh, yes.
How do you spend your spare time?
I give all my spare time to the Red Cross.
Well, I can't think of a more important way to spend your spare time. What do you do for the Red Cross?
Oh, we, in case of disaster, we help. We drive the blood mobiles, and we get women to help in the volunteer work in collecting funds.
Well, what other kind of jobs are there for Red Cross volunteers?
Oh, there are gray ladies and...
Gray lady?
Mm-hmm.
What does a gray lady do? Take care of Confederate soldiers?
No, she goes into hospitals and reads to the boys and writes letters for them, entertains them. Mm-hmm.
This may be bold of me, but wouldn't the boys find it even more entertaining if you mixed up a few blondes and redheads with the gray ladies?
Oh, well, there are gray ladies who are blondes and redheads.
Isn't science wonderful? Are there many volunteers working for the Red Cross these days?
Yes, but we can always use more, and we can use more blood donors. Mm-hmm.
I wonder if the American people realize the importance of the work you're doing. We need more women like you, Mrs. Ross. What is the name of your pet store, Mr. Blanchard?
Beverly Pet Shop, 448 North Beverly Drive, Crestview, 50820.
And if the St. Bernard answers, hang up. What kind of pets do you sell in your store?
No, cats, dogs, fish, birds.
Well, what do you feed your different pets?
Oh, we feed the cats cat food, and dogs dog food, fish food.
So you get logical answers from these people. Anything unusual ever happen in your pet shop? Like your customers giving you the bird?
Oh. Well, we have had a biology teacher come in and ask for a female mouse that was with mouse. And
the mouse was with mice?
And definitely.
And what happened?
Jokingly, I stated that if the... if a mother had any babies before the sale was completed, that it would cost him 25 cents for each additional mouse. Before I could complete the sale, why, the mouse had her first baby. And he laughed quite a bit and laid down a quarter. And with that, four more came along. Boom, boom, boom. So before the man left, he had 18 mice.
Good thing he didn't come in to buy an elephant. He'd have known immediately. I've always wondered about pet stores. Why do you always put puppies in the window?
Well, they have the most appeal.
I'm sure I can think of something that would have more appeal than that. You ever been down to the beach, Mr. And you know what I'm talking about, eh?
I understand.
You put a live whale in your window, old boy, and I guarantee it. Told you, didn't I, eh? You thought I was going to say an octopus. Well, you make a very interesting couple. And if I want a pet, I'll be sure to keep out of your store. Now, let's see how well you work together as a team. You're going to play You Bet Your Life for a chance at $6,000. I can't tell you how much our first couple won, but Fenneman's offstage to remind our listeners.
The Coast Guardsman and the Colonel's daughter won $274.
Here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected Name the Fruit. How much are you going to bet?
We'll bet half of it.
Half of it. That means you're going to bet 10?
That's right. Mm-hmm.
What kind of fruit is a Valencia?
Orange.
An orange is right.
And you're on your way. You have $30.
Good thing we didn't have the Coast Guard boy. He'd have probably said a navel orange. Now, remember, you're going for $6,000 tonight. Now, how much of the $30 are you going to bet?
Do you want to bet half of that? 25?
Over now.
25?
Talk over your partners.
Fine.
25. What kind of fruit is a Concord?
A grape.
Grape is right.
Now, you find the $55.
Here's your third question. How much of the 55 are you going to bet?
Let's make it 50.
50.
What kind of fruit is a bellflower?
Apple.
An apple.
You now have $105.
Here's your last chance to beat the other couples. How much of the 105 are you going to bet?
All of it.
All of it. What kind of fruit is a green gage?
Plum.
A plum is right.
And you'll wind up with $210.
Thanks and good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealers.
If you're in the market for a used car, remember this. The place you buy it is your best assurance of getting a real value. That's why it will pay you to get your used car from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Here's where you can buy with confidence. From a reliable and respected business organization that's proud to be a part of your community. Rest assured that the used car you buy from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer, regardless of its make or model, is a good car. Because he has modern equipment and scientific reconditioning, a DeSoto Plymouth dealer is able to offer you really excellent values in used cars. That's why at a DeSoto Plymouth dealer's, you're certain to find the used car that best fills your needs and best fits your pocketbook. And you'll be amazed at the low prices, the easy terms. So if it's a used car you're after, remember, get it from a dealer you know you can trust. For a fair and square deal every time, get your used car from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Groucho, we asked for married couples with unusual occupations who were present tonight. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Mr. and Mrs. Hal Linker. And here they are. Folks, come on in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome for the DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Say the secret word and you win $100 in cash. It's a common word, something you find around the house. Mr. and Mrs. Hal Linker. Linker, eh? Mr. Linker, you certainly have an attractive wife.
Thank you.
Don't thank me. I had nothing to do with it. Where are you from, Hal?
Well, I'm from Washington Heights in New York City.
Oh. Why did you come out here?
Well, I came out here to make a career of lecturing.
Of lecturing?
Yes.
I see. And Mrs. Linker, that's you, I suppose, huh?
Yes.
What is your hometown?
Hafnarfjordur.
Well, Gesundheit. Now then, I asked you, where are you from?
Hafnarfjordur.
Still the same old place, eh? I gave you a chance to change. Now, how do you spell Hafnarfjordur?
H-A-F-N-A-R-F-J-O-R-D-U-R.
Are you sure you're not reading the eye test at the Department of Motor Vehicles? Now, just what is Hafnarfjordur?
It's a suburb of Reykjavik.
Oh, well, you should have said so in the first place. Now, where is... what was that you said?
It's a suburb of Reykjavik.
Yeah, well, where is Reykjavik?
It's the capital of Iceland.
Oh, you're from Iceland, eh? Uh-huh. Then you must be cold. Here, let me rub your hands. Dad, do you notice any difference?
Oh, my hands are still the same.
I'm not talking about your hands. Mine are red hot. I can't keep calling you Mrs. Linker. What's your full name?
Hatla Guðmundsdóttir Linker.
Is that on the Rilla Rock? Would you mind spelling the whole thing out?
Oh, it's a little bit long.
Well, we have plenty of time tonight.
H-A-L-L-A, my first name, and then Guðmundsdóttir, G-U-D-M-U-N-D-S-D-O-T-T-I-R.
Well, by the time you get through with that, the train has left and you're probably around Kansas City. Well, before you married Hal, what was your maiden name, Hadla?
Hadla Guðmundsdóttir.
Hadla Goodman's daughter? Was your father named Goodman's daughter, too?
No, my father's name was Goodman Thordarson. You see, in Iceland, the children, they get their last name from the father's first name by adding son and or daughter to it. The father's first name.
Let me rub your hands again, man. let's see if I get this straight. If I were in Iceland, my little daughter, Melinda, would actually be known as Melinda Groucho's daughter. Is that right?
That's right.
A fine name for a kid to carry all through life. Well, I like her better the way she is. Melinda and Hasenpfeffer. Hal, you were chosen for your unusual occupation. Just what is it?
I'm an illustrated lecturer.
You're illustrated? You mean you're tattooed?
No, I show motion pictures and I lecture while they're running.
Well, wouldn't it be safer if you were running while the lecture was going on?
Well, they're really quite interesting. They're color films of various parts of the world, and people find them very entertaining and very instructive.
I imagine they are. Now, Hadler, what's your occupation?
I help my husband.
What do you do, sell popcorn in the lobby?
No, I act as a secretary to him. I cheer him up and travel with him. Make sure that he doesn't forget appointments.
Does Hadler really do all that for you?
She's my girl Friday.
Hadler, what are you doing Saturday? Hadler, where did you meet your husband? Did you meet him in
Melinda's daughter?
No, I met him in the Gildaskallen restaurant in Reykjavik.
Oh, well, I didn't know that. Would you break this down? How did you meet Hadler?
Well, I was in Iceland making my newest motion picture, and a mutual friend of ours introduced us in this restaurant, and I asked her if she'd like to be in the movie.
You say you asked her if she wanted to be in the movies, and that broke the ice, eh?
Yeah.
I've tried that same line 100 times. Maybe I should go to Iceland. It doesn't seem to work at RKO. Hal, getting back to your lecture racket, tell me, what are some of the places you visited?
Oh, I've been to many places in the world. Tokyo, Hong Kong, Canton, Bangkok, Rangoon, Singapore, Paris, London, Rome, Copenhagen.
Well, you've certainly covered all the spots, haven't you? You've mentioned every place in the world and a couple that are out of this world. Hadler, can you think of any place that he might have skipped?
Well, he didn't mention Hafnarfjörður.
No, he didn't, and we're all very grateful to him, too. Well, it's nice meeting you two from Iceland, and as the sun slowly sinks in the west, we leave this beautiful conversation. Now, let's see how well you make out in the battle for the $6,000. You run your $20 in the more than our other couples, and you'll get a chance at the big question. I can't tell you how much they won, but George Fenneman is offstage to remind our listeners.
The Coast Guardsman and the Colonel's daughter are still ahead with $274.
Now, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected Name the Profession. Here's your first question. How much will you bet?
$15.
Okay. What does an astronomer study?
The stars.
The stars is right.
On your way, you have $35.
Remember, you're going for $6,000 tonight. Now, how much of the $35 are you going to try?
$30.
Mm-hmm. $30. What does a zoologist study?
Animal life.
Animals is right.
You now have $65.
Here's your third question. How much of the $65 are you going to go for?
$60. Let's try $60.
$60. What does a zeismologist study? A zeismologist.
Insects.
Talk it over now.
Mm. Would you pronounce it again?
S-E-I-Z-M-O-L-O-G-I-S-T. It is my stupidity.
Earthquakes
is right. Now, how do you pronounce it?
Seismologist, I
believe. Seismologist.
You now have $125.
Here's your last chance to beat the other couples. How much of the $125 are you going to go for?
Let's try $120.
$120. Okay. What does an archaeologist study?
Ancient history. He studies the remains of ancient civilizations.
That's true enough. Ancient things is right.
Which means you wind up with $245. And that means the Coast Guardsman and the Colonel's daughter with $274 get the chance at the DeSoto Plymouth $6,000 question.
Thanks and good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealers.
Thank you.
Now, I'll ask them the big question in just 1 minute. But first, George, I want to have a serious talk with you. Fenneman, what do you know about your DeSoto Plymouth dealer?
Well, Groucho, I know that he has a beautiful showroom. He has...
Did you know that every DeSoto Plymouth dealer really tries to do his best for a customer?
Well, I was going to say Groucho.
You were going to say Groucho. Why weren't you going to say that DeSoto Plymouth dealers are interested in seeing folks treated fairly and squarely?
And in addition, Groucho...
I never was very good at addition. Now, look, Fenneman, I've been all over the country, and that's the way DeSoto Plymouth dealers are. Friendly, fair, and square.
So, no matter why you come in, whether it's to buy a new car, a used car, or a simple repair job, the best place to go...
is to a DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
You're so right.
Now, let's get on with the big question.
All right. Here's the Coast Guardman and the Colonel's daughter, the winning couple, all ready for the DeSoto Plymouth $6,000 question.
Well, if you win $6,000 here tonight, you can buy Macy's. And you can buy yourself a general, Nancy. Isn't that right, Nancy?
Yes.
See what a memory I have, huh? All right, here we go for $6,000. I'll give you 15 seconds to decide on a single answer between you. Think carefully and, of course, no help from the audience. Here it is. William H. Bonney was shot and killed by Sheriff Pat Garrett. Who was William H. Bonney, a famous outlaw? All right, what is the answer you two have decided upon?
Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid! Hey! Well, Sailor Boy, that was wonderful. Which one had the answer, huh? You did, huh? What are you going to do with all that money?
Oh, goodness.
Buy a new army, huh? What are you going to do with all that money, Nancy?
Help support this one. Buy some war bonds with some of it.
Well, that's a wonderful way to spend the money. And what are you going to do, kid?
Well, I think I'll split it up with some of the fellows at the office and keep the rest to send my little kid sisters to college.
Well, that's wonderful. Well, let's see. Now, you won $6,000 in the quiz, and plus how much in the quiz?
$274.
$6,247?
$74.
$74. You really cleaned up tonight. Congratulations. From the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast, you bet your life.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $1,000. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember, just be sure to visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
Folks, here's a reminder from the National Safety Council. There's no trick to safety. It's just common sense. You Bet Your Life, transcribed from Hollywood, is produced by John Goodell, directed by Robert Dwan and Bernie Smith, music by Jerry Fielding. This is George Fenneman signing off for the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast. Dealer, and find out just what a pleasure this new DeSoto is to ride, to drive, to own.
Now, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected fictional animals and birds. Now, have you met Mr. Fenneman?
How do you do?
Glad to
know you.
Glad to know you.
All right, now here's your first question.
Want me to tell them the rules, Groucho?
Yes, explain the rules. All if right. You remember them, that is.
Let's see. You bet as much of your $20...
I've got too much confidence in you.
You bet as much of your $20 as you want on each of four questions. And the couple that earns the most money gets a chance at the $5,000 DeSoto Plymouth question at the end of the show.
All right, now you selected fictional animals and birds. Here's your first question. How much are you going to bet? You have $20.
$19.
Okay. What kind of an animal is Dumbo?
It's an elephant.
An elephant is right.
And you're off to a good start. You have $39.
Remember, you're going for $5,000 tonight. Now, how much of the $39 are you going to try on this one?
$38.
$38. What kind of an animal is Ferdinand?
It's a bull.
It's a bull.
You're really climbing. You have $77.
Here's your third question. How much of the 77? 78, you're going to bet? You only have...
He wants to borrow a dollar from somebody in the audience. That's really interesting.
Ladies and gentlemen, the secret word tonight is room. R-O-O-M.
Really?
You bet your life. The more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers of America present Groucho Marx in You Bet Your Life, the comedy quiz series produced and transcribed from Hollywood. And here he is, the one, the only...
Groucho! That's me, Groucho Marx. Well, here I am again tonight when one of our couples might take $6,000 away from me. George, that's a lot of money. An all-time record for You Bet Your Life. Now, Mr. Fenneman, who's first to try for the $6,000?
We invited some people from the Coast Guard to the show tonight, and also some daughters of the Army. And just before we went on the air, our $274.
$6,247?
$74.
$74. You really cleaned up tonight. Congratulations. From the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast, You Bet Your Life.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $1,000. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember... Just be sure to visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
Folks, here's a reminder from the National Safety Council. There's no trick to safety. It's just common sense. You Bet Your Life, transcribed from Hollywood, is produced by John Goodell, directed by Robert Dwan and Bernie Smith, music by Jerry Fielding. This is George Fenneman signing off for the more than 3,000 DeSoto Plymouth dealers from coast to coast.
For $5,000, tell me, who was the Dutch governor who made this famous purchase? What is the answer you two have decided upon?
Lord Baltimore?
No, I'm sorry. It's Peter Minuet, first governor of what is now New York. I'm sorry, that's the correct answer. So that means the big question next week will be worth $5,500. Well, you lost the big money, but how much did they win in the quiz, George?
$306.
Congratulations, and thanks to both of you and to all of our contestants on the show tonight.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $5,500. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember... Just be sure to visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer.
Develop their own inherent charm. We think that every woman is charming, but we'd like to
help
her develop it even
more.
Oh,
what a line she's got, huh? How much does all this rigmarole cost?
Well, right here in Hollywood, the complete course costs $195. However, I've just completed for those women all over the United States who can't be right here in Hollywood what I call a home study course, the 24 Steps to Loveliness, for only $5.
Well, let's pretend I'm a young girl hot out of Vassar.
And I want some charm. Now, what would you do first?
First of all, we have to determine the shape of the face. For instance, each woman's face falls in a geographical, or rather, a geometrical type of design. Yes. Like
most,
it is geography.
Most of the women
me.
I know, their face falls the minute they see me.
Well, for instance, a woman might have a round.
What is the ideal face?
Well, the ideal shaped face is what we call the oval, and if we wanted to measure it out, it would measure like, the eyes should be one eye apart, and the width of the face should be the width of five eyes, and the eyebrow should be the width of an open eye above the eye, and the mouth should be the length of two eyes.
Well, I've counted 36 eyes so far. I'd be better off going out with a potato. I mean, a sweet potato. Well, is all this supposed to hook a husband for your pupils? Or do you teach them specifically how to do that, too?
Yes, we do. We have a class called Your Man in Marriage.
Your Man in Marriage?
Yes.
Pet Shop, 448 North Beverly Drive, Crestview, 50820.
And if the St. Bernard answers, hang up. What kind of pets do you sell in your store?
No, cats, dogs. Fish, birds.
Well, what do you feed your different pets?
Oh, we feed the cats cat food, and dogs dog food, fish food.
So you get logical answers from these people. Anything unusual ever happen in your pet shop, like your customers giving you the bird?
Oh, well, we have had a biology teacher come in and ask for a female mouse that was with mouse. And
the mouse was with mice?
And definitely.
And what happened?
Jokingly, I stated that if the if mother had any babies before the sale was completed, that it would cost him 25 cents for each additional mouse. Before I could complete the sale, why, the mouse had her first baby. And he laughed quite a bit, and laid down a quarter, and with that, four more came along. Boom, boom, boom. So, before the man left, he had 18 mice.
Good thing he didn't come in to buy an elephant. He'd have known immediately. Purchased by the Dutch for $24. For $5,000, tell me, who was the Dutch governor who made this famous purchase? What is the answer you two have decided upon?
Lord Baltimore?
No, I'm sorry. It's Peter Minuet, first governor of what is now New York. I'm sorry, that's the correct answer. So that means the big question next week will be worth $5,500. Well, you lost the big money, but how much did they win in the quiz, George?
$306.
Congratulations, and thanks to both of you and to all of our contestants on the show tonight.
Be sure to tune in again next Wednesday night at this time for the Groucho Marx Show, when the big question will be worth $5,500. And don't miss Groucho's television show, also presented by the DeSoto Plymouth Dealers of America. And remember, all dealers who sell DeSoto also sell Plymouth. Two great cars, both products of the Chrysler Corporation.
And when you drive in, tell them Groucho sent you. Good night, folks, and remember, just be sure to visit your DeSoto.
It's Inga Borg. And here they are. Folks, come on in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome, kids, to You Bet Your Life. Say the secret word and you'll divide $100. It's a common word, something you see every day. You're the oldest man in the audience?
No, I'm a cigarette girl.
Oh. Well, you'll have to pardon me. My eyes are not what they used to be. Hans Vanjana? You must be the oldest man, huh? Hannes Vanjana, huh? What is your name in English?
Hannes Vanjana.
I think I know your brother, Hannes and Truly. Is that him? Hannes Vanjana. It sounds just the same in English. What kind of a name is that, Hannes?
Norwegian.
No, Norwegian, huh?
Now, you were selected as the oldest man in our audience. How old are you? 85?
No.
90?
Older than that.
I'll do my best, but I'm no kid either, you know. Are you 91?
No.
95?
Keep going.
This is getting to sound like the price of coffee. Okay, I'll shoot the moon. Are you 100 years old?
More than that.
No. 200?
Boston?
Los Angeles. It's right down here on Wilshire Boulevard.
They've gone...
Let me another question. This is for $10. If you get this right, I'll give you $10. And please, no coaching. Now, think carefully. This is a toughie. Who is this from Grant's tomb?
Grant.
General Grant is right. Thanks for good luck from the Minnesota Primitive.
Now, Groucho, we invited some beauty contest winners to the program tonight, and just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Vera Miles. Her partner is a bachelor, Mr. Victor Desney. Folks, come in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Well, welcome for the DeSoto Plymouth Dealer. Say the secret word and you will divide $100. It's a common word, something you always have with you. A beauty contest winner. Now you're talking. This calls for a little closer inspection. Well, your name is Vera Miles?
Yes, that's right.
That's a very pretty name, and you're a very beautiful girl. Where are you from?
I'm originally from Kansas.
From Kansas?
Mm-hmm.
May I ask how old you are?
20.
Well, I'm a man of very few words, Vera. How about joining me at a big party after the show? Would you like that?
It sounds like a lot of fun.
How do you know it'll be a lot of fun? You don't even know who's going to be there. You want to know, Vera?
Yes, who's going to be there?
Just you and I. Does that still sound like fun? Answer yes or no, Vera. It's between you. Think carefully and, of course, no help from the audience. Here it is. William H. Bonney was shot and killed by Sheriff Pat Garrett. Who was William H. Bonney, a famous outlaw? All right, what is the answer you two have decided upon?
Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid! Hey! Well, sailor boy, that was wonderful. Which one had the answer, huh? You did, huh? What are you going to do with all that money?
Oh, goodness.
Buy a new army, huh? What are you going to do with all that money, Nancy?
Help support this one. Buy some war bonds with some of it.
Well, that's a wonderful way to spend the money. And what are you going to do, kid?
Well, I think I'll split it up with some of the fellows up the office and keep the rest to send my little kid sisters to college.
Well, that's wonderful. Well, let's see. Now, you won $6,000 in the...
Well, that, folks, should give you a pretty good idea of the new DeSoto's greater safety. And when you add to that its extra comfort, you'll discover why DeSoto is your best buy for the years ahead. So visit your DeSoto Plymouth dealer tomorrow and see this beautiful 1951 DeSoto for yourself.
Now, let's see if you'll get the chance at the $5,500. George, Mr. Fenneman, would you mind explaining the rules to this old trapper over here?
You bet as much of your $20 as you want on each of four questions, and the couple that earns the most money gets a chance at the $5,500 DeSoto Plymouth question at the end of the show.
All right, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected fighting presidents. Here's your first question. How much of the $20 will you bet?
Just make it about 18.
Go ahead.
Might as well shoot
it. Yeah, okay.
18.
This one thing, if we don't win, you won't be too disappointed, will you?
No, I won't, but I think you will. I want everybody to win on this show.
Thank you.
It's not my money. Now, what was the... What was the name of the president who led the Union forces during the Civil War?
Grant.
U.S. Grant is right.
you fellows are on your way. You have $38.
Remember, you're going for $5,000.
Is your best assurance of getting a real value. That's why it will pay you to get your used car from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Here's where you can buy with confidence. From a reliable and respected business organization that's proud to be a part of your community. Rest assured that the used car you buy from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer, regardless of its make or model, is a good car. Because he has modern equipment and scientific reconditioning, a DeSoto Plymouth dealer is able to offer you really excellent values in used cars. That's why at a DeSoto Plymouth dealer's, you're certain to find the used car that best fills your needs and best fits your pocketbook. And you'll be amazed at the low prices, the easy terms. So if it's a used car you're after, remember, get it from a dealer you know you can trust. For a fair and square deal every time, get your used car from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Groucho, we asked for married couples with unusual occupations who were present tonight. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Mr. and Mrs. Hal Linker. And here they are. Folks, come on in here and meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome for the DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Say the secret word and you win $100 in cash. It's a common word, something you find around the house. This one.
All of it. Something the while is made for fun and frolic. And so do I, and so do I. Some think it's well to be all melancholy, to pine and sigh, to pine and sigh. But I love to spend my time, and I don't always get a chance to sing. And sing. Particularly, yeah. Thank you all.
Well, you have $4.
I need $4. It's your last chance to be the other couples. How much of the $4 are you going to bet?
Bet all of it.
You're going to bet all of it. That was a shame, that one question. Okay, is your last chance to be the other couples. You're going to bet $4. Da, 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 da. They say such things and they do strange things. And da, 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 da. I'll never go there anymore. Da, 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 da.
The Bowery.
The Bowery is right. Yeah, you can't do it.
I should say you did come through because your $8 total means that you get the chance of the DeSoto Plymouth $5,500 question.
Well, I'll ask them the big question in just 1 minute. What's your life? Now, Mr. Fenneman, who's first to try for the $6,000?
We invited some people from the Coast Guard to the show tonight, and also some daughters of the Army. And just before we went on the air, our studio audience selected Miss Nancy Dunn and Yeoman Jean Scarcliffe. And here they are. Folks, meet Groucho Marx.
Welcome, youngsters, for the DeSoto Plymouth dealers. Say the secret word and divide $100. It's a common word, something you'll find around the house. You're Nancy Dunn. You're an Army daughter?
Yes.
I didn't know the Army had any daughters. Those new secret weapons, I suppose. Where are you from, Nance?
I was born in Fort Bragg, North Carolina.
And you're from the Coast Guard?
Yes, sir.
Jean Scarlett, huh?
Yes.
Where are you from, Jean?
Los Angeles.
Uh-huh. How old are you?
23.
Why are you 23?
Well...
You don't know why you're 23? Couldn't you say that it was because you were born 23 years ago? I hope you're more alert when you're on the coast looking for ships. Are you married, Jean?
No.
You know, you answered that pretty quick. You're an Army daughter?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Just what is an Army daughter?
It's a daughter of an Army officer that was born and raised in the Army.
I see. In other words, you've been in the Army since your early infantry. Is that right? God, boy, he'd have probably said a naval orange. Now, remember, you're going for $6,000 tonight. Now, how much of the $30 are you going to bet?
Do you want to bet half of that? 25?
Now,
25?
Talk over your partners.
Fine.
25. What kind of fruit is a Concord?
A grape.
Grape is right.
Now, you find the $55.
Here's your third question. How much of the $55 are you going to bet?
Let's make it 50.
50. What kind of fruit is a bellflower?
Apple.
An apple.
You now have $105.
Here's your last chance to beat the other couples. How much of the $105 you going to bet?
All of it.
What kind of fruit is a green gage?
Plum.
A plum is right.
And you'll wind up with $210.
Thanks and good luck from the DeSoto Plymouth dealers.
If you're in the market for a used car, remember this. The place you buy it is your best assurance of getting a real value. That's why it will pay you to get your used car from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Here's where you can buy with confidence, from a reliable and respected business organization that's proud to be a part of your community. Rest assured that the used car you buy from a DeSoto Plymouth dealer, regardless of its make or model,
should signal the engineer to stop the train.
That's not true. By the time I figured out the question, the correct thing to do would be to call an ambulance. Well, I've learned a lot about intelligence. Quotients, is that what you call it?
That's right.
Now, let's see if you two are smart enough to run your $20 into more than our other couples. And then you can take away the $5,500 from me. Now, Mr. Fannerman, that's George, is offstage to remind our listeners how much the first couple won.
The Western character and the Indian won $7.
All right, here we go. Let's see how high I can build you $20. You selected famous hotels. Here's your first question. How much will you bet?
18.
He's an undercover man. He used to sell lingerie. In what city is the Palmer House Hotel?
Chicago.
Chicago, Chicago.
On your way, you have $38.
Remember, you're going for $5,500 tonight. That's the most we ever had. How much of your $38 are you going to bet this time?
Mm-hmm.
How much?
$35.
In what city is the Mark Hopkins Hotel?
Atlantic City.
I'm sorry, kids. It's San Francisco. You should have known that. It's a very famous hotel, and you've been on the road all these years.
You have $3 now.
Oh, that's a shame. Here's your third question. Not married, huh?
Mm-mm.
Well, you're a cigarette girl. Where do you peddle these weeds?
In Ciro's.
In Ciro's,
mm-hmm.
Huh? Oh. Do you sell smokes behind a tobacco counter?
No, I usually walk around and sell cigarettes on the floor.
Well, is that where the customers are, on the floor? Wouldn't it be cheaper for the management to install a cigarette machine?
Yes, but there's a lot of difference between a cigarette machine and a cigarette girl.
Really? Do you mind if I take another look at you? Yes, by George, you're right. There is a difference. I never saw a cigarette machine wearing high heels. I've seen a lot of heels around a cigarette machine. Now, Hannes, in what year were you born?
January the 21st, 49.
1849. Who was the first president you can remember distinctly?
Abraham Lincoln, the first Republican president.
Well, a man has to be pretty old to remember a Republican president. What would you say is the secret of your long life? Longevity.
All right, Groucho, and here's the beauty contest winner and the bachelor. Would you come over here, please? The winning couple, all ready for the DeSoto Plymouth $5,500 question.
All right, here we go. For $5,500, I'll give you 15 seconds to decide on a single answer between you. Think carefully and, of course, no help from the audience. Here it is. One of our greatest men isn't as well known as he should be. See if you can tell me who he is for $5,500. He was our first Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Who was he? All right, what's
what's the answer you two have decided upon?
Johnson? No.
No, it's John Jay, oh. J-A-Y.
Oh, I knew.
I'm terribly sorry. Well, that means the big question next week will be worth $6,000. Well, you lost the big money, but you won $8 in the quiz. Congratulations. And, oh, $100 for the... Oh, you got $108? Well, that's not too bad.
No. Yeah.
Congratulations and thanks to both of you and to all of our contestants on the show tonight.
Thank you.
Well, you'll have to pardon me. My eyes are not what they used to be. Hans Vanjana? You must be the oldest man, huh? Hannes Vanjana, huh? What is your name in English?
Hannes Vanjana.
I think I know your brother, Hannes and Truly. Is that him? Hannes Vanjana. Sounds just the same in English. What kind of a name is that, Hannes?
Norwegian.
Norwegian, huh? Now, you were selected as the oldest man in our audience. How old are you? 85?
No.
90?
Older than that.
I'll do my best, but I'm no kid either, you know. Are you 91?
No.
95?
Keep going.
This is getting to sound like the price of coffee. Okay, I'll shoot the moon. Are you 100 years old?
More than that.
No. 200? That's as high as I'll go. I give up, Hannes. How old are you?
102.
102 years old? Well, old-timer, what sort of work do you do?
I work down at Knott's Berry Farm down here in Orange County.
Knott's Berry Farm?
Mm-hmm.
I know what it's not, but what is it?
Well, it's a berry farm. A feller by the name of Knott started it.
What is a berry farm?
Well, it's a pretty good-sized spread now. He's got 300-400 acres there, and he's got big chicken dining rooms and steakhouse where he serves a lot of people.
How many people do you feed out there?
Well, I reckon about the biggest time they had was last Father's Day. There was about 11,000, a little over, out there for dinners.
On Father's Day, you saved 11,000 dinners?
That's right.
Well, that's typical. 11,000 mothers decided to celebrate Father's Day by letting the old man take them all out to dinner. Now, let's see how well you work together as a team. Now, in just 1 minute, you're going to play your Bet Your Life for a chance at $5,500. But first, there's something of importance I want you to hear about.
When you drive the new 1951 DeSoto, you'll enjoy added comfort and pleasure thanks to DeSoto's famous Auraflow shock absorbers, a longer wheelbase, and a full cradled ride. Yes, no other car rides like a DeSoto. And DeSobs that will assure you of thousands of miles of trouble-free driving. So no matter what kind of car you own, stop in for that really thorough spring tune-up at the sign of a DeSoto Plymouth dealer. Any of the more than 3,000 authorized DeSoto Plymouth dealers will be happy to serve you promptly, efficiently, and at a fair price.
All right, Groucho, and here's the beauty contest winner and the bachelor. Would you come over here, please? The winning couple, all ready for the DeSoto Plymouth $5,500 question.
All right, here we go. For $5,500, I'll give you 15 seconds to decide on a single answer between you. Think carefully and, of course, no help from the audience. Here it is. One of our greatest men isn't as well known as he should be. See if you can tell me who he is for $5,500. He was our first Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. Who was he? All right, what's the answer you two have decided upon?
Johnson?
No. No, it's
It's John Jay, oh. J-A-Y.
Oh, I knew it.
I'm terribly sorry. Well, that means the big question next week will... If I keep on chattering, I'll not only prove I'm a dope, but also that I'm broke. Let's talk about this intelligence testing. Who do you work for, Gene? Oh, I forgot I was talking to intelligence. I beg your pardon. Whom do you work for? I have to be careful. Somebody from the New Yorker might be listening. Who do you work for, Gene?
I work for the Educational Testing Service.
Well, what kind of a racket is that? What do they do?
We test the high school seniors who are applying for entrance into college.
Let me see you try it on Bill over here. Huh? Ask him some questions. Go ahead, Gene.
Well, Bill, if it takes 3 men 6 days to finish a job, how many men can finish that same job in 12 days?
I'd say 4.
Why don't you? Now, Gene, what would you say? Would you say he's right?
No, the right answer to that is a man and a half.
That may be the right answer, but where are you going to hire a half a man? Of course, you could hire one, but I won't be out of work until summer. Now, Gene, I don't think that was a fair question. Try another one where the answer is a whole man. Now, go ahead. What's another of your test questions?
Well, here's one for you, Groucho. If you see a train approaching very fast on a track, and you see
it's a good place for it.
And if you see that a piece of rail is missing from the track, what would you do?
I get off and take the American Airlines. $500. Now, how much of the $38 would you bet on your second question?
35 and a half.
What is the name of the president who served with the 129th Field Artillery during the First World War?
Truman.
Harry Truman is right. If he's an Indian, I'm a monkey's uncle. I don't think that couldn't be true.
You have 30, 70.
Get this massive mathematician here.
I had it for a minute.
Where do you live? I bet you don't know where you live.
Yes, I do. 15300. I live up there.
You,
you don't, you have. Here it is right here. $73.50.
All right. Now, how much of this are you going to risk this time?
73. No, 70.
70.
Leave 3 and a half.
Let me get a hamburger out of this.
Cheap said he hopes to get enough for a hamburger out of this. What was the name of the president who was a major general in the Civil War? He was assassinated by a disappointed office seeker.
Major general. He ain't saying which side of the fence he was on. Could have been in the South or the Yankee field.
Oh. Oh, the $6,000 question. But first, here's something of interest to everyone.
Folks, one of the most important things you look for in a new car is real honest-to-goodness comfort. Well, you can stop looking right now, because you'll find that the new 1951 DeSoto is the most comfortable car on the road today. For when you slip behind the wheel of this proud new car, you'll be sitting on comfortable chair-high seats that give you a good, clear view of the road and more real leg room and head and hat room as well. And when you get the new DeSoto actually on the highway, you'll feel DeSoto's new advanced design Auraflow shock absorbers go to work. No matter what kind of highway you're on, from a gentle rolling road to one with plenty of bumps and holes, you'll enjoy the comfort that comes from a really smooth ride. Yes, these are a few of the reasons why we say no other car rides like the beautiful new 1951 DeSoto. And of course, it's DeSoto that lets you drive without shifting. So folks, see the new DeSoto. Buy the new DeSoto.
No other car rides like a DeSoto. All right, now let's see if you two will get a chance at the $6,000. Mr.